All right, guys, we are back.
Get a couple followers.
And
out of anyway.
we got some chatter here in the room. Golden Boy, we're going to let you say it in a minute, but first, methods. Let's talk about losers bracket round two. Remember, this match will decide if you go to Los Angeles to compete for the $1 million tournament or if you're staying at home to watch it on MLG.TV. You and I had envy losing to Optic Gaming. We both said Optic was going to secure their spot in winners round two. Envy over Curse New York. You have Envy here. Why do you pick the boys in blue?
I just don't see NY just clutching it out versus Envy. I see Curse NY. I know Burns can get really down when they're losing. Bayo Finals gets really mad as well. So I just see Envy keeping their composure, Rambo leading that team to victory. And overall, just I'm going to say Envy 3-1 or 3-2. It may go last map, and it may be a close one because Curse NY is really good, but Chilla can go off on any time,
right?
Deal fire. Revan has the brains, and overall, that stuff can be a really good match, but I have Envy taking it at.
All right, you can see in my bracket, I also have Envy moving on against Curse New York. Let's go over to Scott's. Scott, you got Optic over Curse New York. 3-1, 3-2, 3-0 here.
I think it's probably going to be a 3-1. I'm expecting Optic will most likely end up losing the search. I don't have too much faith in their search and destroy. There's just times where it's finicky. And I think Curse New York is one of those teams where you're going to see a lot of strong arm stuns on search. It's just going to be awkward for them to get used to. So with that said, I think Optic beats this and they advance to champs. I think anything less would kind of be like a little bit crazy, but I think it'll be a good match still.
Speaking of crazy, we had one person ballsy enough on this bracket show to tell the world. What, Golden Boy? Go ahead and say it out loud so the fans can hear.
I believe that Optic will lose to Curse New York in losers round two and not make it the Call of Duty Championships.
The power of Christ compels
you. He said that like a guy who's about to walk off a plank of a ship.
I embrace it, honestly, because at this point in my career, I don't care. But I will say that the reason why is I've known Revan for a very long time, and I know that when he really wants something, he's going to do it. He's going to make it happen. And I just believe that he will defeat Optic. Like, he would love for nothing more than to just rub that in so many people's face. Like, he loves that stuff. He relishes in those moments. On top of which, E-Girl Slayers at UMG Philly, they surprised a lot of people and placed higher than Optic at UMG Philly. So this isn't me being an Optic hater. This is me actually going off of actual statistics of events that we've done before. Also, another thing that you want to point out here too, you got Burns who, I feel like Curse New York could really shine in the Blitz game. Burns is actually third place in caps. I think he's a solid player and I always have faith in him. I just feel like this team is going to get hot and that's going to be their moment to do so. A lot of people are doubting Curse New York, and as a fellow New Yorker, I cannot. So that's just my MO there.
Now
I stick with it.
You know what? And Golden
How'd
Boy.
How'd that feel?
I don't know. I'm getting a lot of hate right now, though. I tell you that much.
Delete your Twitter.
I mean,
it's
like
totally
right now, I think I've been death threatened numerous times at this point.
Hey, so. Bro, I got you.
Listen. Put locks in your social security. Hide your car. Hide all your clothing, lock your doors, board everything up.
Yep.
You're going down tonight.
All right. Well, Golden Boy, I do have some stats to back you up as well. I was looking at this.
Pigging Dr. Puckett, we have eyes on the subject. Puckett,
63% win percentage for Curse New York when it comes to search and destroy. If it goes to game 5, Optic Gaming's in trouble. All right, well, it looks like we lost audio to our casters for a moment, but let's go ahead and show their top 8 predictions one by one. We just saw Mr. Golden Boys. He has Denial East based on the bracket advancing into the top 8, but Curse New York is going to slide past Optic Gaming into his top 8. Let's go over to Methods in his top 8. Looking at his bracket, he's got Complexity and Optic Gaming going pretty darn far. Curse Las Vegas and Caliber Walls come from the winner's bracket, and then he has Strictly Business, Justice, Envy, and FaZe securing their spots in the loser's bracket. Up next, we have Gandhi's predictions. And Gandhi, he's been on, he's been off, I guess, when you look at my bracket versus his, but Pretty similar results in our top eight. Complexity, Envy, Curse Las Vegas, and Caliber coming from the winner's bracket. For those bottom seeds, he's got Strictly Business, Justice, Optic Gaming, over Curse New York, and FaZe. So Scott, pretty good stuff there. You're in my top eight are exactly the same.
That's
Golden,
right.
Golden Boy is really the only unique one. He's got Denial East over Strictly Business because he has Final Boss beating them. And then he's got Curse New York over this Optic Gaming squad. So
I'm right now getting bombarded with hate mail. It just, you know, if you have faith in your team, you have no reason to talk crap. That's all I got to say.
I'll give you this. I will go on the record to say this. I think that if Envy does lose to Optic, but one, they have to get through Xfinity. It's very plausible that Xfinity's here. But if Envy does lose to Optic Gaming in round two and everything, everyone gets the match they want and they find themselves in the loser's bracket versus Curse New York. I think just the emotion that sucked out of Envy from losing to Optic, I don't think they would beat Curse New York in that same matchup. Wow.
Yeah, and I feel the same way about Optic losing against Envy. I feel like we've seen this team, and you know everyone's always like, yeah, but it's a new team. But I've known Embos I teamed with Embos, and I know when he loses, he gets very quiet, you know? And I know that's something that has happened in the past. We've seen that with Nate Shot. We've definitely seen it with Scumpy. That's why I made my decision the way it is.
Hey, he's basing it off of stats. And Golden Boy, I don't know if you heard this earlier, but tried to back you up in your decision for Curse New York. If you look at all of the MLG COD League statistics, on-host and off-host combined for all of these teams, Curse New York has the second best search and destroy record. They're sitting at 10 wins, 6 losses for a 63% win percentage. They're only behind, I believe that is going to be FaZe, who's in that number one spot, and ahead of TK, who is 10-7. So three very strong search and destroy squads. If it goes to game 5, either Envy or Optic both have much worse records when it comes to S&D. I believe they're at 42% or 41% and 41% each. So that could be interesting stuff. Morale, a big thing to keep in mind. Guys, we got about 5 minutes left on the show. Before we go, let's talk about who everyone has in the finals method. Stop typing. Who do you got in the grand finals?
I'm not typing. That's not
me. You do type. You're a thumper, man.
That was
you're like a dog with too big a paws walking down the freaking hallway.
No. Stop. That was not me.
Go to the finals.
Go to the finals methods. We're starting with you, thumper.
That was not me.
Methbot, who you got? Grand finals here. Who's the top two seeds coming out of the U.S. Championships, the number one and number two seed in the pool play?
Definitely Complexity and Caliber.
Complexity, Caliber. Here's a look at Method's bracket real quick as we show you what he had going down in the loser's bracket. Of course, he had Strictly Business Justice. Strictly Business moves on to go up against Optic Gaming. There, Optic loses to Caliber, who beat FaZe, and Caliber will beat Curse Las Vegas to lose to Complexity in the grand final. Up next, it's Gandhi's turn. Gandhi, you got Team Caliber here. Talk me through your loser's bracket.
All right, so I firmly believe, I don't know if you want the whole story, it could be a long one here. I believe TK is going to find themselves up against a very hot FaZe in the loser's bracket finals. They're going to beat them in a 3-1, and then when it comes back to playing Complexity, I truly think that Complexity might be at a place where they're just complacent, right? Like, they're in the finals. They already beat TK. Right now, Complexity, if you're Complexity, you know that there's one team that get into the finals that they can beat you. That's Curse Las Vegas. Curse Las Vegas always falls short. They know if they play TK, it's almost a guaranteed win every single time. I think as long as Formal shows up and he doesn't just hold on to the freaking thermal scope every single time in S&D rounds, I think this team can take it.
So far, it looks like the world is saying Optic Gaming is going to win the grand finals. But Golden Boy, let's go to your bracket. Who do you have matching up in the U.S. Championship match?
You know, I think that we're going to see Justice Complexity going in the finals. I think this is Justice's time to shine. Gucci and Tipsy, they're hungry for that recognition. And I also believe, because I have Justice and Caliber going up against one another in the loser bracket final. And I just feel like Neslo is just going to give 150% when it comes to going up against Caliber. That's going to be a toss-up, but I tip my hat over to Justice strictly because of Gucci and Tipsy, but I got Complexity winning it and getting the top seed.
Wow. All right. And then in my bracket, you know, big shout out to Golden Boy being ballsy with his predictions here. I like that you're backing it up on fact as well. But you're saying Justice is going to be Envy, Curse Las Vegas is going to not even get to the losers final, and Justice is going to make it all the way to that finals. Yeah. I went Curse Las Vegas in the final here, guys. I think they beat the Caliber in the winter semis. I don't know why. I just feel like if they get past their second round matchup, they're going to be having a lot of confidence. They're going to be on the same page, and they won't be arguing quite yet. They'll be happy. They just secured a spot at the World Championship, and when they're having fun, that's when they're dangerous. So I have Curse Las Vegas going to the winner's final, struggling against Complexity. And look at this. Go to my bracket here, Lennox, and show the fanboys how I accidentally rode this one all the way. Optic Gaming and Envy, I have facing off in the loser's semis. I don't know why. I think it's the Optic fandom, the live event fans that are going to get Optic Gaming fired up. And then Envy, we were talking about how we were worried about them against Curse New York. I think they're going to be pissed off that they lost to Optic. They're going to play with rage. That's going to carry them through New York. That confidence will get them past FaZe. And it's going to be a game five between Caliber or Envy. In the end, Envy runs out of gas. Optic Gaming loses to Curse Las Vegas. And I'm going to go ahead and write this champion in right here. This is a pride match. People say, what is there to play for after Top 8? Of course, it's World Championship seeds, but this is Karma versus his three former teammates at the World Championship. I got Complexity with the addition of Karma, my number one player, and all of Black Ops 2 helping his team get by. So, boys, I think we covered everything. Before we go, you got 2 minutes each. Golden Boy, start it off. Who is your player to watch for the entire tournament?
Me. Ooh. I'm going first. I got it. The player to watch for the entire tournament is not because of skill. It's not because of anything. It's the person who has the most to prove, and that is Formal. Formal made the switch over from Halo. TK is the second seed. If they fall anything less than second place for this team, who have only been in top two since Ghost has come out, Formal's to blame.
Ooh, tough stuff. Methods, who you got? Who's your player to watch for the entire event?
I'm going to have to say Study. Study just coming from Justice to Envy. I feel like Study's been playing really well online in the league. I think he's a really good player. He's very very vocal, and you really wouldn't expect that, you know, of him, but definitely Study. The man's really good at Search and Destroy. Pretty much where he came from. In MW3, he was a GBS and D-Star, so definitely Study. I want to see what he can do this event.
And Golden Boy, your player to watch for this tournament?
You know what? It's a toss-up because there's a lot of players to look out for, but I think the one player that I am keeping a keen eye on is definitely Scumpy, because a lot of, like, I don't know why he left a team in Envy that could have formed into something really great with maybe one or two more changes. I thought there was a lot of great chemistry there. But going into Optic, you know, I'm really looking for him to be that co-pilot when it comes to the hype on the team. And if he can manage to sustain that alongside Klaser, and on top of that, slay his heart out, which we know Scumpy's capable of doing, then my bracket will be completely wrong. But I will say this much, Scumpy is definitely going to be someone you got to look out for throughout this tournament.
And I'm going to go with the guy that I couldn't stop watching at the Columbus tournament. I'm going with Classic from FaZe. If FaZe is going to go far, if they're going to secure a top 8 win, I think it's going to be FaZe's Classic. He had a 9 or 11 kill spree that we were able to catch on broadcast. He was very confident talking to him at Philly. He started off very strong against Complexity, but he kind of fell off in that Blitz game, and that's where the momentum started to shift back in Complexity's favor. If FaZe is going to perform extremely well in this U.S. Championships, I think he's going to be a big reason for it. I think he is the X factor for that FaZe lineup.
Classic's a beast, yeah. He's a former teammate. I mean, if he gets up in your face and your base, he's going to just lay you down and that guy when he's on a roll.
You're such a poet.
All right, guys, we got matches kicking off in 3 minutes. And of course.
This is awkward. We should end it here.
Yeah.
No,
Shut up, Methods. Guys, we're going to close out the show. Thank you for tuning in for the U.S. Championships Bracket Show. Coming up next, of course, Desi and I have the eSports Report. We talk about more than just Call of Duty, but of course, Call of Duty will be the first segment in today's show. And of course, tune in to the U.S. Championships. It's going down in Winter Park, Florida this weekend, March 8th. At noon. That is Saturday. We kick off at noon. First match of the day, Complexity versus Final Boss. We'll see how Golden Boys do in round number one. And then, of course, the top eight continues. We'll find out all eight teams who are moving on Saturday. Top eight continues on Sunday, kicking off at 10 a.m. Of course, after that, it is the Million Dollar Tournament. We'll talk about that in a few weeks to come. But tell your friends, the U.S. Championships for Call of Duty Ghosts going down this Saturday. It all starts at noon Eastern, 9 o'clock Pacific, 6 o'clock if you're in England. All right, guys, thanks for tuning in. I'm Chris Puggett, and I'll see you next time right here on the eSports Report.
Sure.
Best Call of Duty teams fight for a chance at $1 million. Only on MLG.TV.